This hole is where the star tracker will be mounted. That's the device that will look out at the stars and point the rocket and make sure that it's exactly on target for the desired observations.
Imaging on. We have counts, 1500 counts. Looks pretty nice.
The star tracker is basically it's a camera with a computer attached to it. It can look out at the stars and tell you where it's pointed. It can do it very rapidly and very accurately. And knowing where you're pointed is something that rockets need to do once they get above the atmosphere.
There's nothing like it. When you try to collect data on an astronomical object on a rocket, you have like 5 minutes of data collection. That's all you have. So you need to be able to quickly figure out where you are and point exactly to the target that the scientist is interested in observing. And this all has to happen very quickly. And that's what the star tracker does very well.
Imaging high voltage on. We have 1400 counts. I see it right in the middle. Right in the middle.
Exposed, right in the middle.
Right smack in the middle.
Hey.
The comet is called Comet ISON, and it came from the outer edges of the solar system. They're made of the same material that the sun formed out of. It's sort of like original material. As they come in around the sun, they heat up, they give off lots of gas, and you can study this gas to learn about the conditions in which the solar system formed. The light will pass down through the body of the telescope, and NASA really sort of launched an all-out observing pattern for this. They used satellites in orbit, ground-based observatories, and the suborbital rocket. And a suborbital rocket can be launched on a much shorter timeline than a satellite. We heard about the comet. This team was able to put together an instrument to observe it on a fairly short lead time, and we could get it launched in time to do its observations.
I'm going to end the zoomy. I think we're doing good.
Some of these scientists were used to the previous lower precision systems.
We got a smooth flight.
And when they saw the comet appear in their detector, right on target, they were pleased. NASA doesn't fly many copies of the same thing. They're interested in new science or new technology with each flight, which will then be leveraged into more expensive things like Earth orbiting satellites, all these fancy things you hear about in the Hubble telescope. All of those technologies were developed in these smaller rockets.